Hello friends, welcome to the MOOC on Academic Counseling for Open and Distance Learning, ODL Learners. In the previous video, we dealt with what is academic counseling, difference between academic counseling and tutoring, and activities of academic counseling. In this video, we shall be discussing about the stages of academic counseling. As we all are aware that activities performed by academic counselors has been divided in three parts. They are informing, advising, and counseling. Now we will discuss the various stages through which the learner may come across and academic counselors might have to help the learners to overcome the difficulties at these stages. These stages have been categorized into five stages, but an academic counselor has to see that these are just for understanding of the counselor and these are not watertight compartments. It may vary from university to university and based on the needs of the learners. The stages are pre-entry stage, entry to the course, during the course, examination, post-course stage. These stages help the academic counselors to focus on the learner's upcoming needs and planning for the upcoming stage accordingly. Mentioning again that these segments, these stages are not at all isolated or watertight compartments, rather work as an indicator for academic counselors. First is the pre-entry stage. Pre-entry stage is the time when a learner wants to change his or her situation in terms of education and improve and change the job prospects and opportunities. At this stage, the learner wants to know about the programs available in distance education, entry requirements for the program, the university, regional centers, study centers of the university, application procedure, fee details, etc. At this stage, the learner may not be clear about what he or she wants to do or wants to study. Learners at this stage need a mix of information, advice, and counseling. At this stage, learner needs information or support about programs, course, entry requirement, duration of the program, examination fee, fee structure overall, etc. He or she needs advice or guidance about the program and connecting it with their prior knowledge of the learner and selecting the appropriate program for learning. Learner needs counseling about selection of course as per the choice and interest of the candidate and to identify a line of action for the future. So at this point, academic counselors should have detailed information, not just about the programs available in the particular study center, but also about all the programs available or running in the university or the ODL institution. They need to keep an updated prospectus, brochures of the programs and courses for guiding the learners on various aspects. The second stage is entry to the course. Now, when the learner has decided to take some course, in the next step, learner would require information related to the course, like number of credit courses in the program, assignment submission details, advice on studying the course. However, the learners are given a program guide at the beginning of the course, having a lot of relevant information about the course, with an aim to do general counseling. Apart from the information needed by the learners, sometimes they need advice about handling the workload and their success through the course. Here, a counselor can help them find ways of handling the workload, time management for effective studies. Also, the academic counselor inducts the learners into the instructional system of the university or the ODL institution at this particular stage. The next stage is the during the course, when the course has already started. Once the course has started, the learner has new queries or difficulties. These can also be looked at two levels. At one beginning stage, once the child or the learner is admitted to the course, he or she needs guidance about the paperwork, learning material, academic difficulties, assignment preparation, and overall system. Learner in the ODL system may be adults returning to the studies after a long gap and may have low confidence. Here, the academic counselor needs to motivate the learners, build their confidence, and give constructive help to move further in the particular course. At level 2 or mid-course stage, learners face academic difficulties. Personal and non-academic problems also sometimes crop up, which indirectly affect the studies of the learner. The problem can be at home or at office, or it can be even health related. The academic counselor must listen to all the problems explained by the learner and help them to overcome those and able to focus on their studies. The next is the examination stage, counseling stage for everybody in any system of learning. So here, examination in any system basically brings anxiety in learners, irrespective of their age and experience. In distance learning, learners become extra anxious due to less interactivity with the system, and it needs to be handled by the academic counselor. They need advice on preparing for the examination and revision techniques. The learner need information regarding the time, date, and venue of the examinations. Academic counselor needs to give counseling to overcome examination anxiety and conduct dummy exams for the practice. Academic counselors need to plan and discuss question type strategies to answer the questions with the learners prior to the exams. Mock exam, practice revision, and discussion on examination pattern. All these can also help the learners sail through the exams smoothly and properly. The next stage is the post-course stage, that is the last stage in these 5 stages. Academic counselors shall be careful as their responsibility do not end with the end of examinations. After the exams also, the learners need support of the academic counselors to advise and guide them about career opportunities and their suitability and career advancement. They also need information about results, grades, awards, convocation, and other related issues. The academic counselors at every stage need to be empathetic towards the learners. It is also seen that some learners overcome the barriers easily, whereas some learners need hand-holding at every stage, every step. That is it for this video. In the next video, we shall be discussing about media for counseling. Thank you.